I was out on my travels there a while ago, and I popped in to see another wood turner there by the name of Brendan. He has a channel there by Bacon Soda. Maybe a few of you out there know him. And he gave me a big bag of timber there of yew. I'll show you a big chunk of it. There it is there. There's a big lovely piece of it. Anyway, I'm going to make something with a small piece of it. Not with that one there now. But I'm just going to take one of the pieces here, and I'm going to just put it on the lathe and make a nice little vase out of that there. Just a little simple project. Now, so this stuff, I don't know how dry it is. It seems not too bad, but it doesn't matter. I'm going to take as thin as possible so it doesn't actually crack. But yew is pretty nice stuff to work with anyway. It's a nice timber. So stick it on the lathe and I'll take you through the process and see how it goes, okay? I want to say to Brendan, thanks for all the timber, Brendan, and it was very nice to meet you. And everyone should check out his channel. He's plenty of gardening to offer and good few wood turning videos. And he says he's going to make a new channel just for wood turning. So when that happens, we'll be looking forward to it. But he does have a few wood turning videos starting up now anyway. So check him out anyway if a few of you out there don't know him. But I'm sure most of you do. He's around a long time. He's on YouTube there a long time anyway. Okay, so let's see what happens with this piece of wood. I'm just basically going to put it in between centres to put a tenant on the end of it, so I can put it on a chuck. And I was just looking at it. It must have been a crotch in this piece of wood, because there's two pits in it. There's a pit there and a pit there. And this end has the pit on one side, just here. So I think I might make this the opening piece, but the thing about it is it's lost a bit of bark there. And I'd like to have the bark up here. But it's fairly long, so I might end up, I'll pour the tenant down on this end and turn this back and get rid of this. I'll just peel off that when I have the tenant on it. So I'll put it in here, put a tenant on here, put it in the chuck, cut that away, and I'll start from there, okay? So basically just going to make a tenant on this end down here. So that's the four states. 50 mil tenant and a 5/8 bowl gouge that's going to use just to do that. Just put this piece now in the chuck. I have to cut this back to there now to get rid of that bark that I lost there. I lost a little bit of bark there, so hopefully you don't lose any more. Pour into this. Basically going to do is drill out a bit here just to make it a bit easier for me to hollow. So just a bit of bore on here. Just take a bit out of here. What I just did there was I put a bit of super glue around, or CA glue around the edge of that bark, just to toughen it up a bit, and I will be taking a nice slice and cut off it. I'm going to remove a bit of this wood here from the centre just to try and take this into balance before I start emptying out the inside and put a little bit of shape in the first. because it's a bit wobbly as it is, okay? And I'm just going to use a 5/8 ball gouge, just a long swept back grind, and I'll just put a bit of shape on this. And it's a bit wobbly as it is. Start taking the inside out of the piece now, okay? Okay, I'm just going to start hollowing out the inside. I'm just going to use a 5/8 ball gouge. I'm just going to try and get a nice clean cut on the front of it here. Just clean on that bark there. With the speed now, I have balance there. Just make sure I'm getting a nice clean cut. That's not worried about anything else. A little bit of bark there, so it's broken. Just keep on and get a lovely piece of bark. That's all I'm interested in here at the moment, is getting a nice piece of bark. Now, I'll actually move up and I'm going to use a different chisel just to get a cleaner cut. Now we can start taking the inside out. But this is all end grain, so putting right into the end grain with a ball gouge. Use a hollowing tool if you want to do this. What I'm going to do now, the inside is just nice to there. I'll take the outside the same thickness, just down to the same depth. And once I get the rim done, I'm happy then, because the rim is going to be really the hardest part of the whole project is the rim. Just to get that nice rim and not to lose the bark. So I'm happy enough with the inside of the rim. So before it starts moving, because there is a bit of moisture in it, and we'll have to get the outside done now. So I'm going to just move on to the outside. The whole thing about this is just take your time. One false mistake and you just lost, the whole lot is gone down the drain. And you just lose it in a matter of one catch and the whole lot will just blow up on you. Back onto the inside of it now. Okay, I'm just going to start shaping the outside of the vase, okay? Basically what I'm going to do now is go inside and finish the inside of it now that I have me define what kind of a shape that I'm going to go on the outside. So I'm going to hollow the inside out to that thickness, okay? Going to finish up down in the bottom of it here, just going to give it a little scrape out on the very end of it here with a scraper, just to clean out just a few little bumps in there that I left with the bowl gouge, and just clean it out with a little scraper, little round nose scraper on this tool here, and that'll tidy her up and that'll be the inside ready for sanding. That's it. I'll just give that a little bit of sanding now on the inside and take it on to the next stage. It's time to finish off the outside of the vase, so I just have a bit of foam wrapped around my revolving tailstock here, and I'm just going to put it inside it gently there. It's just to give me a bit of stability, make it a bit stable while I'm torn. It'll stop the vibration. Just have that rubbing, don't need to have to be too tight. We'll be right back. Right, what I'm going to do now is just tidy up this little cove here I've done. I'm not really happy with it. It's a bit too heavy. I want to refine it a bit smaller and tidy up this in a bit more tighter. And there's two little fillets on the end there. I want to make them a bit more tighter with this chisel. Round over the tip of this and clean off the base of it here. Just put a little point, bring it down as small as I can at the moment so I can still work on it. Sand it up, put some oil on it, and that'll be it. It'll be finished. Okay. Okay, just going to sand her up now and put some oil on it, and then I'll part her off. Putting some oil on it and just giving it a bit of a buff up. I put a bit of paste wax on it. I'm just giving it a bit of a rub there now with a paper towel. And I'm going to part her off now, off the end here. Just cut that away there, and that's it. Okay, there we go. There's the finished piece. There's the bottom. I just sanded it up there and put some oil on the base. And I just finished that with liquid paraffin and a bit of paste wax. And that's it there now. That's the finish. It's just a matte finish kind of on it. It's a lovely piece of yew. Has a nice bit of sapwood on the side of it there, and it's nice there. The pit actually was the one side, it's just the one side of it there, just over to one side. There was a bit of a crotch kind of on one side of it. The branch, there must have been a little branch going through it. It was a lovely piece of wood, nice to turn. So I hope you all enjoyed the video, and I'll see you all again soon. Bye now.